In this section, now we will discuss electron transport chain. We have talked of glycolysis and Krebs cycle. So this is our step number 3 for aerobic respiration. The structure which I have drawn here is the middle, or you can say the inner membrane of mitochondria. Now this is inner, so inner side of the inner membrane would be the matrix, and on the outer side there is going to be an outer membrane. So this is the outer membrane of mitochondria. The space between the inner and the outer membrane is known as external mitochondrial space or intermembrane space. Electron transport chain takes place in the inner membrane of mitochondria. Let me write matrix here so that we are able to write other things in this particular area. Now what happens, NADH and FADH2, which we have obtained during glycolysis as well as Krebs cycle, they will release electrons and protons, and those electrons pass through these chains. So these structures which we have drawn here are the electron acceptors, and because this is a membrane, these are protein molecules which are intrinsic proteins. They are completely embedded in the membrane. So now if we say that NADH2 breaks off into a pair of electrons and a pair of protons, plus NAD is regenerated, protons accumulate in the matrix, whereas electrons will pass through this electron transport chain. The first electron acceptor is FMN. So this pair of electron through FMN and these electron acceptors will finally come to the bottom of this electron chain. One more thing which we need to add here is these electron acceptors are divided into 4 complexes. Together they are termed as complexes also. This is complex number 1, 2, this is complex 3, and cytochrome is complex 4. This will help us understand in which step the energy is released. Now when electron passes down the gradient, it releases the energy. So from all these electron acceptors, when electron comes from FMN to FES, that is in first complex, energy is released here. In this particular segment, energy is released. This energy is utilized to pump a pair of proton from the matrix into this intermembrane space or outer compartment. So utilizing this energy, from here a proton will be pumped out. So a pair comes here. The electron further goes down this gradient through these electron acceptors, and when it is passing through ubiquinone, it releases some more energy. And this energy will again be utilized to pump a proton pair into the outer compartment. So till now there are 2 steps where the energy has been released. The electron with lesser energy is coming down the gradient. When it passes through the next ubiquinone here, it is going to release the energy 3rd time, and again utilizing this energy, a pair of proton will be pumped out. Finally, through cytochrome C1, C and A and A3, This electron will be given to the atom of oxygen. We cannot write O, so we are writing half molecule, that means one atom of oxygen. In this entire process, we see that the energy is released from the pair of electrons at three places. At complex 1, 2 and 3. In complex 4, energy is not released. But there are three places where energy is given out. And at every place, a pair of protons from the matrix was pumped out into the outer compartment. The last electron acceptor in this electron transport chain is A3. And finally, when the electron comes out of the chain, it is accepted by oxygen. This oxygen receives this pair of electron. It also receives a pair of proton from the matrix. And now, with proton and this electron, it will change into the water molecule. So this water is generated from here at the end of electron transport chain. In this electron transport chain, the maximum questions which are asked are in the stages in which energies are released, that is in which complex, 1, 2 and 3. Second important question which is asked is, which is the final electron acceptor in electron transport chain? If it says in electron transport chain, that means we are talking about these electron acceptors. So our answer is going to be cytochrome A3. And if the question says which is the final electron acceptor, then our answer is going to be O2. Because they have not mentioned electron transport chain. So while answering the question, we need to read it very, very carefully. So from one NADH2, three times the energy was released and three pairs of protons were pumped out. Now, in this outer compartment, there is a higher concentration of protons. And we know these ions or any particle tends to move from higher concentration to lower concentration by the process of diffusion. But they can go back only through F0, F1 particles. And that is the next step, that is oxidative phosphorylation.